got it the first time. I totally got it the first time. But the second time, I think you were just riding past it. You didn't really have the pace you needed. I told you the Corvette story, right? Yesterday, remember the Corvette story? Is it that you feel that the brakes aren't going to work? Be honest with me.
No, it's just
that
you want to, like, get there and then not have them drive. So
well, it's the same idea where you're putting a future fear, for lack of a better word, you're putting a future concern. That's the word I'm looking for. You're putting a future concern into your equation, which creates an environment where you can't succeed. Does that make sense? You can't stymie yourself like that. Instead, your mind has to have some clarity that I'm going to jump the first one with momentum. I'm going to land. I'm going to put my leg on. I'm going to get into the line. And I'm going to take a little feel for the five. I'm going to go forward. And I'm going to take a little feel. That's the only way you need to be thinking. Not, well, what if this goes bad? So I'll get ahead of that problem and ride weak in the first place. See where I'm coming from? Intent, your intent when you're thinking like that is setting you up for something bad to happen. The other intent is putting you in a position for something good to happen. Always put yourself in a position for something good to happen. Okay? If you have to improvise, great. But don't plan on improvising. See the difference? The first time I gave you the benefit of doubt is because you had to improvise. I don't think you need to. Job done.
Good job. I didn't get that on the tape.
changed the environment. I just changed the environment. You know, when they're like that, they're like a bacteria. Change the environment, die. Goes away. Goes away. So, don't be lazy. The first thing I do, he wants to buck when I go forward. Why do you think he wants to buck? He doesn't want me to go forward. He doesn't want to go forward. So then once I'm like, buck all you want, we're going forward. I'm like, darn it, that was one of my best moves. And then as I come to jump, I'm pulling together. He wants me to get squeamish. I don't get squeamish. Darn it, that was another one of my best moves. And then over here, showing the corners black and white. He thought about it. You can see it in his eyes. He thought about it. But he thought, I'm not going to do that. This guy's not going to let me get away with this. All right, now I'm standing here.
He's being gentle.
Only because I don't play his game. Smart. You'll never outmuscle him. You've got to outsmart him. Okay? So let's see. I'm going to come over here. We need to stand back over there. I want to see if he's going to do the green one. Standing up, and I can like move along in. Probably. Be my guess.
So, Richard, just to check on the time, Richard. I know you're probably going to need about 15 or 20 more minutes.
Yeah, okay. I think okay. We're just about ready for the final lap. All right, you're back on it, Lane. You're not gonna need it. One, two. Okay, we're at the top. Now, we're not at the top, I'm sorry, then go ahead. You guys gotta help me out. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, I've been taping the whole time.
You taped it?
Mm-hmm.